everyone! Welcome back to IntegralCalc.com. Today we're going to be doing a double integrals problem. And this one is the integral from 0 to 2 of the integral from 0 to 4 of 3x plus 4y dx dy. So with any double integrals problem, the first thing that we need to do is recognize that we've got two sets of notation. One is the inner integral here. And the other one is the outer integral here. So if we draw brackets that way, we can see that the first integral is going to be taken with respect to x, because we've got dx here inside the first integral. So we're going to completely ignore the outside for now, the integral from 0 to 2, and dy we're going to ignore. And we're just going to look at what's inside the orange right here. So we're going to be taking the integral with respect to dx, because dx is this innermost derivative notation. So we need to take the integral of 3x plus 4y with respect to x from 0 to 4. So we'll do that first. Taking the derivative with respect to x, we will, like I said, we'll ignore the 0 to 2 for now, so we're just going to write it out there, but then draw big brackets so we can kind of just take the section of what we're going to do. So to take the integral with respect to x of 3x is not challenging. It's just like a regular integral. We would add 1 to the exponent, which is an implied 1. So 1 plus 1 gives us 2, x squared, and then we would divide the coefficient 3 by the new exponent, 2. So 3 halves x squared is the integral of 3x. Taking the integral of 4y with respect to x is a little bit trickier, but not too bad. So remember that if we're just taking a normal integral, the most basic integral you can think of, right? And you've got, say we had like 3x plus 4, right? The integral would be 3 halves x squared plus 4x, because this 4 here is a constant, and we would just tack on the x variable to the constant. Well, in this case, because we're taking the integral with respect to x, we're treating y as a constant. So 4 times y is also going to be a constant, which means that to take the integral of that, we're just going to tack on an x variable, just like we did here. So the integral will be 4y times x, which of course just simplifies to 4xy. So that's the integral, and then we're going to be evaluating that on the range 0 to 4, given limits of integration of our inside integral here. So we're going to do that, and then we've just got dy written out here. We don't need the dx again, because we just took the integral with respect to x, so this dx notation goes away. So we still need to continue simplifying what's inside of our integral before we go ahead and take the integral with respect to y. So doing so, we'll plug in 4 first. So 4 squared plus 4, and we're plugging it in for x because we took the integral with respect to x. So we're going to be plugging in for x and leaving y as it is. So we plug in for x, leave y as it is, and then we subtract what we get when we plug in 0, so 0 squared plus 4 times 0 times y, and then dy. Oh, sorry, forgot my limits of integration for y from 0 to 2. All right, 0 to 2. So now, let's see, 4 squared is 16. 16 times 3 is 48, divided by 2 is 24, so this whole term here simplifies to 24. Plus 16y, and then this is going to reduce to 0, and this is going to reduce to 0. So that is, we fully simplified what's inside the integral. Now that we've fully simplified this, we can proceed to taking the integral with respect to y. So doing that, of course, will give us 24y, right? Just like we said, up here when we've got the constant inside, we just add the variable. Well, now with respect to y, we're just going to add the y variable to the constant 24. And then as far as 16y, we're going to add 1 to the exponent. 1 plus 1 gives us 2. We divide the coefficient 16 by the new exponent 2, and our integral is 16 halves y squared. And we're going to be evaluating that on the range 0 to 2. So just to give us some more room here, 0 to 2. Okay, so now we're going to go ahead and plug in our limits of integration. So doing that, we'll get 24 times 2 plus, and this is actually going to simplify, let's write this here. This would simplify to 24y plus 16 over 2 is 8, so 8y squared on the range 0 to 2. All right, so 24 times 2 plus 8 times 2 squared minus what we get when we plug in 0, so 24 times 0 plus 8 times 0 squared, okay? And that'll give us 48 plus 2 squared is 4 times 8 is 32. This will reduce to 0 and this will reduce to 0, so we don't have to worry about that. 48 plus 32 is 80. So that's it. That's our final answer. This double integral simplifies to 80. So I hope that video helped you guys, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye!